we're talking about this utility pole. Now, Regis and Mary Lou Wessel told me they pulled into their driveway in August and found the big surprise. For them, this has been a three-month nightmare.
This is what Regis Wessel saw, towering over his home. He made a beeline for the borough building.
And I asked, well, what the hell's going on up there? Oh, you mean the pole? And I said, yeah, why are they putting the pole in front of my house? And he says, Duquesne Light tells us where to put the pole, and we have no choice.
I stepped out on the porch, and I was so upset, I just couldn't believe it. It was hard to fathom.
3 months later, it is still hard to fathom. The Wessels feel they've been getting the runaround ever since. They started snapping photos. Here, crews are installing the transformers. Here's one crew member waving to the camera. Regis and Mary Lou say they can't escape looking at that pole. This is what they see in the morning when they look out their bathroom window. Here's the shot from their kitchen and living room. They even showed me what it looks like from their deck out back. Yep, there's that pole. The Wessels tell me they've been attending meetings for about 2 years, staying informed about the new library being planned and built next door. But they say they were never told about a utility pole built so closely to their home.
I don't know that they had to inform us legally, but I think as a neighbor they could have done that, but they didn't.
They have unsuccessfully been fighting to get that pole moved. Regis and Mary Lou have kept records of their letters and conversations with the borough, library officials, the architect, and Duquesne Light. The utility company offered to slice the pole in half and build another smaller pole closer to the road, but the Wessels said no thanks. Looking at two poles would be worse than one. Frustration levels are high.
Well, I just hate it. I'm sorry, but that's what I just hate looking at it all the time, to be quite honest with you. I don't always joke about it because it's not funny. I mean, what they did was really unconscionable.
If you click onto the Fox Chapel website, it says it constantly strives to defend and maintain its special ambiance. Fox Chapel is a classic example of what can be done to preserve a rural atmosphere in the very midst of urbanization and industrialization.
The serenity is one of the biggest reasons that Reg and Mary Lou bought this dream farmhouse back in 1989. That's why they say they can't believe no one in the borough is fighting hard for them to get rid of this 50-foot monster, which sits just 34 feet from their house.
They try to laugh about the mess. Regis made this sign for their scarecrow, but the stress is clearly mounting, and there are bouts of sadness.
Oh, I'm not happy at all, really. I mean, there have been days it's been very difficult, really difficult.
Tears?
Oh, yes, plenty of those, and I don't want to start now.
The Wessels worry if the transformer will blow someday or if a car crashes into the pole and it topples. It has turned their twilight years in their dream home into a nightmare.
At our ages, we'd like to be able to enjoy our home for what time we have left.
For like the leaves of autumn, they just want us to blow away and accept what they're doing, and we just can't do it.
Well, let me tell you, those leaves aren't blowing away. They're not going to go away. I've been trying to help them. I talked to the borough manager, the library director, the architect, Duquesne Light. Bottom line here, while everyone was very understanding what they're going through, they say the pole simply cannot move at all. And Andrew and Wendy, Duquesne Light told me because there are water, sewer, and gas lines underneath there, an underground installation like the Wessels really want simply can't be done.
It's such a beautiful home. Such
isn't
a,
it? They've restored every single room.
Well, and of course, that home is their life right now. I mean, what can they do?
Well, here's the deal. Yeah. They really worry about their property value more than anything else.
Right, right.
And I talked to a real estate agent walking me through the math. Roughly, the agent said if you have an acre in Fox Chapel, it's worth roughly $350,000. Mm-hmm. You put a pole like that near your property, you can chop $100,000 right off. Now, I've been working to try to find a solution. We can't find a solution. So that's why we're turning to you tonight. If you have any ideas, perhaps maybe you have gone through something similar that the Wessels are going through, you can contact us here at the station, 412-244-4444, or just shoot me an email. My email address is mjclark@hearst.com. These appear to be just two great citizens. Mm-hmm. They put four kids through college, got them off. They wanted to retire in their dream home. They just want some help.